very old iPhone 4 that cannot even load my own app. I can't load the mindful check-in app or anything. So I was waiting for the iPhone 8 so that I can decide to upgrade. But as I looked at the price of iPhone 8, which is 1,200 and above, I decided that it would cause too big a damage to a very poor nun. So at that point, of course I can still pay, because you can pay by installments, right? You can pay by installments, I can still pay, but I have a bigger decision to make. Because if I were to invest $1,200 onto a phone, it means that I'm going to change my lifestyle, right? If I spend that much, I am going to buy an iPhone that much money, I'm going to spend a lot of time on it to make sure I make $1,200 use of that phone.
Yeah.
Is that the lifestyle that I'll choose? And I decided that I want to be a master of the device, rather than to let the device be my master. So, thanks to Joe, he helped me select a $300 new iPhone SE. And that's good enough, because it has enough power for whatever use I'm going to make of it. And so I'm going to let you know, now I will have a new phone number. And also, I'm going to make sure that the phone is going to start work at 8 in the morning after breakfast, and it will retire for the day by 6 p.m. just before dinner.
Very good.
So that is going to be its work hours, the same as my work hours. I will work from 9 to 5, we'll work from 8 to 6. But what does that tell me? That tells me, first of all, when I enter this digital world, 20 some years ago, I was in IT research and development. So I actually know a lot about phones. I was one of the first few people in Singapore to own a mobile phone. And I also know the damage it will do to the body and to the mind. Mm-hmm. It has caused me to be a lot more distracted as a result. So knowing all these, we have to make decisions in our lives. So do we follow the current trend? And the current trend is, let social media dictate my daily schedule. Or do I make a decision to step out? So it's a revolution, isn't it? It's stepping out. But you know that stepping out means I'm now vulnerable. It's increasing my sense of vulnerability, because everybody else will be connected from 6 p.m. to 8 a.m. the next day, and I'm not. That means I'm no longer social. I'm not in that peer group anymore.
Aren't you?
Well done. Okay, so I was getting really worried about you.
But it's a choice.
Yeah.
So we all have the ability and the power to make a choice. So what does self-empowerment really mean? The Buddha is a very self-empowered being, because he's able to start controlling everything in his mind. You can't control others. So others can be connected between 6 p.m. and 8 a.m. But I can choose what I'm going to do during that period of time. And I can then choose to be vulnerable in that sense, but also become empowered in another sense.
I thought it gave you freedom.
That's right. So what is real freedom?
Well, it's not having something own you. It's not being a slave to something, not having this attachment or addiction.
Yes.
Yeah.
So if you think of a boat in an ocean, if a boat is all anchored down with a lot of anchors, it cannot move. There's very few degrees of freedom. And what we are doing as our practice of Buddhahood is to remove an anchor at a time, so that we can increase our degrees of freedom, so that we can flow a little bit, so that we can go with the flow. We can't go with the flow if I'm constantly anchored. And then it's also to choose which flow, which stream do I want